What is the coolest website you've visited that no one knows about? Thanks. I now have 300 open tabs in my browser. www.thispersondoesnotexist.com shows you a computer-generated image of a person every time you refresh. Sometimes there are some weird artifacts in the images, but often they look very real. www.bash.org It's text chat logs from old school internet chat rooms. Formatted somewhat like Reddit's best of. You can upvote or downvote and it only shows top of all time. Some short ones as highlights hum. I've lost a machine. Literally lost. It responds to ping. It works completely. I just can't figure out where in my apartment it is. Hey. You know what sucks? Vacuums hey. You know what sucks in a metaphorical sense? Black holes hey. You know what just isn't cool? Lava. Hi everybody. Try pressing the caps lock key oh thanks. It's so much easier to write now. Me also. Hunter 2 and Blood Ninja. But the first places I saw either. jcharles.net/drive used to be a guy who had set up a radio control car in his living room with a camera attached live streaming. And allowed everyone on the page 2 minutes to drive it via their computer. This was around 2008. Then one day he just took it down sad face. send.firefox.com You can send a 1 GB to 2.5 GB of files, videos, pictures, just everything, to others just by uploading the file to this site, then send the link to your recipient. You can even put a password and expiration for the file. You don't even need an account to use the service and it is totally secured. Safe. And free. Welp. This is gonna be 50 new saved comments. postsecret.com New secrets from anonymous strangers every Sunday. Been checking since I was 18. Edit. I'm 31 now. Photomath You can take pictures of math problems and it solves it while showing the steps on how to do it. Carried me through many homework assignments. I'm not telling you WADS anything about my cherished untrafficked websites upon which you will all muddy up with your cookies. It's mine, all mine. Microsoft official support. It's a cool website where you give your personal info to some Indian dude so he can get rid of spyware on your computer. Back in the early oohs when schools started to get actual IT admins and internet blockers for inappropriate content. We found a website called thefinancepage.com that was full of business news and stock feeds and all links went into proper articles. It really did look very professional. But right on the main page there was a small invisible box about 5x5px and when clicked took you into a treasure trove of in-flash games. Edit. Don't think the website loads up anymore. www.creedthoughts.gov.www Creedthoughts a blog by a learned man in his 70s. Well, he will be 80 this November. Cyber world needs more of these. Not a website. But a game GOGUESSR not a lot of people know. You are dropped randomly on Google Street View and have to guess the place. Library of Babel. Too lazy to get the link. Sorry. It's a website that contains every possible combination of English characters. With a search tool to find exact matches of character combinations. Apparently around here it's Reddit. I'm always surprised whenever I mention it to coworkers. Family. Yada yada. And no one knows what it is. Found one called Pornhub.com earlier today. New to me, but I had a very positive response and think you all will really enjoy it. Hackthebox.eu You can practice hacking different things once you create an account. The catch? You have to hack your way into the site to create one. So if you can't hack and make your own account, you can't try the other stuff either. It's really fun, but I suck at hacking, so I've only been able to beat one activity, lol. I stumbled onto a fake NBAstore.com site from an Instagram ad a long time ago and took the risk to buy 3 jerseys for about $100 total, very cheap for NBA, Lakers jerseys. 2 were Kobe's, and after a sketchy Chinese foreign transaction fee and 2 weeks of no delivery, I received 3 perfectly authentic jerseys in the mail. The site is impossible to find now. I have a theory that a group of people stole them from the factory in China and sold them for a short period of time. Nexus Mods. Best modding community I know. www.libraryofbabel.info You can search for everything. Literally everything that has been said or could be said is on it. It is mind-boggling. Think of a sentence and it is there. You have to check it out once at least. www.vertex42.com. This has free spreadsheets you can download for pretty much any situation you can think of: monthly budgets, debt payment calculators, mortgage calculators, to-do lists, chore charts, school schedules, time logs, March Madness brackets. As a nerd, this is my favorite website. SleepyTie.me is a simple sleep cycle calculator website. Pretty useful. Nanite installer app. Whenever you get or image a new computer, this can install apps you need. I like the classic Windows. Turns Win10 into a Win7 feel. Nuke map. You can simulate nukes in different places. Not exactly the coolest, but I'm really impressed not that many people know about Krunker.io. Jazzradio.com and ClassicalRadio.com are pure professional bliss. And they aren't only twin websites but also have their respective mobile apps. Headbone Zone, no link because it's no longer up anywhere. It was a site for kids in the late 90s that included, among other things, moderated chat rooms, tycoon games, puzzle games, and my favorite, a user-driven celebrity stock market with stocks like Britney Spears, Melissa Joan Hart, Backstreet Boys, Ricky Martin, etc., which due to being user-driven could be played in ways similar to the real stock market to win big. If you knew what you were doing, I wish it were still up for my kids. It was marketed to adolescents but treated them like real people with entire brains, which I appreciated. Forebears.io, it lets you look up the frequency, rank and distribution of your first or last name in the world. Really interesting to look up different names. Pornhub.com, it's an upcoming website for young and upcoming artists. I visit it at least once per day to be inspired. Not the coolest, but definitely noteworthy because of how detailed and long it's been online. Mayhem.net. It's dedicated to the work of serial killers, cults, and conspiracies. Some links lead to obscure websites. Some lead to epilepsy-inducing images and loud noises. I was shown the site around 15 to 17 years ago by my older brother. The site regularly gets updated but doesn't seem to change. Yes. The site is still up and running too. Honestly, it seems kinda like it's just a shock site. But the amount of information on the site seems more like the owner idealizes serial killers. I wouldn't recommend going on the site to anyone. It's genuinely weird. Arrowhead and the discussion board Blue Light have saved many lives through drug harm reduction. Unfortunately, I've noticed the Google search results for an obscure drug no longer lead you to Arrowhead or Blue Light or even the wiki. Not just the ads, but the whole first page is rehab sites with massive amounts of disinformation. Disinformation and scaremongering makes people lose trust in the info they're getting. Which is why we need qualified chemists, toxicologists, and experienced users helping each other. In this age where there's spice, synthetic cannabis, NBOME sold as LSD, and fentanyl sold as heroin, we need harm reduction services more than ever. Wayback Machine. Want to see the McDonald's website from 1995? Sure. Want to see that a website took down questionable content after an event? Go back and view it. Backyard Ballistics. It was one of the first sites I found online. I learned how to build my own advanced potato delivery system. It was some weird psychedelic website I accidentally clicked on a few years back. There was this tall long black worm, and anytime you moved the mouse quickly it would set up this crazy LSD strobe scene. I can't remember what it was called. Beautiful? I'm not sure, but it was pretty entertaining as a kid. Beanbeanbean.com, every time you get a question right, the site donates one bean to people who can't access, pay for food. www.homestarrunner.com, sadly no longer exists. Was taken down years ago. Had some of the most hilarious original cartoons I have ever seen. I had a hoodie with one of their characters on it, which some tweaker stole out of my car. That hoodie was literally priceless and irreplaceable. Purple.com used to be awesomeness. It was just a purple page. Then the Purple Mattress Company bought it and now it sucks. I am so angry that I stumbled onto this thread. I only have so much free time. Find the invisible cow. Best way to pass time. Period. The bitchy waitress. It used to be the angry waitress and had really funny nastiness from your waitress. And you thought she enjoyed serving you? Nah. Not so much. Anyway, I can't find it anymore, so it may be a pleasant memory. Why so angry, Julia? Oh, you're sick of this lowlife. I see you. Face with tears of joy.